Good day. Here are the top stories of the Manila Times for November 18, 2020. The government may pass another stimulus package or a third version of the Bayanihan Law if this year's national budget is not sufficient to help the victims of the recent typhoons that ravaged Luzon and parts of the Visayas, Malacañang said on Tuesday. In his press briefing in Alcalá, Cagayan, Palace spokesman Harry Roque Jr. said Finance Secretary Carlos Dominguez III informed him that his department is evaluating this year's budget to determine whether there was need to augment it. He issued a statement after Senate President pro tempore Ralph Recto raised the possibility of passing another Bayanihan Law this year to help the people affected by recent typhoons. Cases of coronavirus surged in the cities of Baguio and Davao in November, a report by the Okta Research Group said. The report dated November 16 said that two cities have become, quote, hotspots of serious concern because of the significant spike of cases that, if not contained, may cause, quote, high hospital burden in the coming weeks that may overwhelm their medical frontliners. Data logged from November 8 to 14 showed that Davao City registered an average of 104 cases per day, down from the 130 average new cases per day from November 1 to 7, with an attack rate of 5.9%. Baguio City, meanwhile, had an average of 44 cases per day from November 8 to 14, slightly up from the 40 cases per day from November 1 to 7, with an attack rate of 11.2%. Hospital capacities in Davao City and Baguio City are above 80%. The world should react with the same urgency to climate change as to the coronavirus crisis, the Red Cross said on Tuesday, warning that global warming poses a greater threat than the COVID-19. Even as the pandemic rages, climate change is not taking a break from wreaking havoc. The International Federation of Red Cross and Red Crescent Societies, or IFRC, said in a new report. On global catastrophes since the 1960s, the Geneva-based organization pointed out that the world had been hit by more than 100 disasters, many of them climate-related, since the World Health Organization declared a pandemic in March. It added that more than 50 million people had been affected. In other news, Caritas Manila, the social arm of Archdiocese of Manila, warned the public against donation scammers using the organization's name to solicit money for victims of the two recent typhoons. Caritas Executive Director Father Anton Pascual made the warning following reports that unauthorized individuals or groups pretending to be from Caritas were taking advantage of typhoon relief operations. He advised the public to get directly in touch with Caritas Manila or through the parishes of the Archdiocese for their donations. The charitable agency is currently gathering aid for the victims of Typhoons Rolly with international name Goni and Ulysses or Vamco that devastated several parts of the country. In business, Finance Secretary Carlos Dominguez III said there is no need for the national government to borrow money than it planned this year, as he believes the Philippine economy will bounce back next year with the availability of COVID-19 vaccine. It can be recalled that the government plans to borrow 3 trillion pesos from domestic and external sources this year. The amount is 195% higher than 2019's 1.01 trillion pesos. Dominguez added that he also do not see the need for more central bank borrowing, quote, at this point. On top of world news, the World Health Organization, or WHO, on Tuesday, Wednesday in Manila, launched a strategy to rid the world of cervical cancer, stressing that broad use of vaccines, new tests, and treatments could save 5 million lives by 2050. More than 500,000 new cases of cervical cancer are diagnosed around the world each year. Hundreds of thousands of women die from the disease, and the WHO warns will rise significantly in the years to come without action. In sports, the Barangay Ginebra Gin Kings and the Meralco Bolts will renew their rivalry as the two protagonists clash in a best-of-five semifinal series today, November 18, in the PBA Season 45 Philippine Cup at the Angeles University Foundation Sports and Cultural Center in Angeles, Pampanga. Ginebra will try to assert its master over Meralco, whom they defeated thrice in the Governor's Cup Championship match. The two teams fought for the Governor's Cup crown in seasons 2016, 2017, and 2019, with the former walking away victorious. Meralco is hoping to finally find the answer against the powerhouse Ginebra when the series starts today at 6:45 p.m. Rigoberto Teglao is the Times featured columnist on the front page. He writes about how efficiently several ex-generals have functioned on their posts under the Duterte administration, and how the Yellows and the Reds have demonized the military for three decades since Marcos fell, with the former painting them as, quote, agents of martial law and the latter as their enemies, since it is military men who have gone after them. In its editorial, Times talks about the Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership, or RCEP, trade agreement. The paper denied critics' claims that it will primarily benefit Chinese industries at the expense of domestic businesses in the other participating countries. Read the full version of the editorial in the paper's opinion section or listen to the voice of the Times. For more news and information, get a copy of the Manila Times on print. Subscribe to its digital edition or log on to www.manilatimes.net. Follow us on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. And keep up with the Times!